This is Pharaoh Vincent with Nation 506, coming to you with another video, this one to expand upon my previous video where I'm talking about how to gain free power progression. And I wanted to start with officers, and the main reason is they do make up a majority of your stats super late into the game, but they're also a good source of early statistics for a lot of individuals. And I'm going to have a hot take in this, just a spoiler alert ahead of time. There's going to be something by the end of this video that I'm going to talk about what officers I would prioritize that is going to be against what your alliance is telling you, and it's going to be against what most people perceive as the conventional wisdom of the game. It's a mistake that I made and a lot of other people have made, where we're focusing so much on the wrong area. So, not to get all doom and gloom, everything can be fixed, and obviously all these officers are good. So, provided you're killing zombies, you're going to start getting a lot more of these officer EXP. You're going to be getting officer skill EXP, officer, like, actual experience to gain them levels. And although the game doesn't do a good job of telling you, the maximum level of an officer is 55. If you are a war city, which I am, there's not a lot of benefit in leveling up your directors. As you can see, I have 5 stars and my breakthrough skill unlocked on I am a DC. And, you know, every rank I would give him is only going to give me 1.25% extra gather speed. And I don't need that. I'm doing fine on resources. I don't really need what he gives me because it's not going to increase your combat effectiveness. Officers like Morgan and Saki, who have abilities that allow you to increase the size of your fleet, have a direct correlation to your combat statistics, right? Officers like Simon and Katie also have the ability to affect your troops in combat, right? You're increasing damage for a period of time. You're decreasing your enemy damage for a period of time, or specifically attack, right? Officers like Tifa, who I think is a very good officer, but not the best. Despite the fact that I'm level 49, you can tell where I put a lot more of my focus in. Tifa is not the best officer, but we'll get into that in a moment. Increasing your attack is very good. It is the higher base multiplier that you're going to be getting. It really gives you a foundation in which to attack. And these officer skill EXP books that I get allow me to get my officers up levels, right? I have books that I've gained for free killing zombies. All of this that you see here isn't purchased. I haven't bought officer packs. I'm not picking up officer specific things. Like, this level that I can gain right here increases all of my statistics just by a little bit. And this is all done for free. I want to challenge anyone watching this video today of see how much experience you can get in a week by maximizing your zombie kill. Make sure you don't hit 100 fuel. Kill the highest level zombie you can. And see how much officer experience you get in a week, and you'll be surprised. You know, I can get an officer level just about every day to every other day. And I mean, that's even in the 30s. It is possible to do for free. And every time you increase these levels, you do get a little bit of benefit, right? So this kind of gets me to the crux of the video and my hot take for anyone listening. Well, but who's the best officers to level? If I don't think it's Tifa, which, again, I know your alliance is telling you Tifa is the best officer. She's not. Some people will be like, oh, well, clearly it's Saki and Morgan, right? They're amazing. They increase how many troops you can send out. But if your troops are complete garbage, there's no point in sending out more. If you're sending out more of garbage, yeah, you might be able to brute force something down, but you're not winning the fight. Panda is great. Siege army. When you're attacking somebody, you're getting more attack and hit points. And that's nice because you're getting 2 stats. And generally, it's weighted about the same as Tifa's attack increase. So, I mean, that's a really good skill, but it's still not the best. The best officers in AOZ are Zeus, and Alexandria. The best officers, pound for pound, are Zeus and Alexandria. And without getting too far into the weeds, it has everything to do with damage taken from all troop types. And this is a reduction to damage taken. And this is an increase to damage dealt. The reason why that is important is it will help you to flatten or increase the curve between you and the higher tier player that you're fighting against. If everything else is created equal, you will smash them. If they are stronger than you, but you have higher increased damage dealt, or decrease or reduction to damage taken, you will be able to take bigger fights. My recommendation, though, is really to keep all of your officers about the same. And the reason being is it has to do with the baseline. I wouldn't just shoot up to 49 levels on Tifa like I did. Right, I have her here. There's no point in changing it right now because I don't need to take the hit. She's a good officer. She's, to me, at least third, maybe fourth if you want to fight for Panda. But for me, I would always level up your officers in terms of Alexandria, Zeus, Tifa, Panda, and then Aeon, and finally Stormbow. And that's just based around the stats that they give you. As you can see, I have generally everyone around the same level. I do have a slightly higher level on my strategy officers. And that's just because having that additional troop type was something that I was really focused on for a long time. But, you know, you will realize at some point in this game that the best thing you can do is make sure that it's an even playing field. And then smash your opponent. The difference between you and the super spender on your nation is that they have a higher increase in reduction to damage. It's not just their attack. Their attacks are high. But if they have a higher increase to damage taken, that's how players like Ram can take on 25 to 30 people at a time. That's why players out there in these nations that are big and have a lot more statistics can take on these odd man fights. It comes down to these stats that these two officers give you, and we don't do a good enough job talking about it. So I highly, highly, highly recommend that everyone take this challenge. Level up your officers. Get them all around the same level for your strategy, your drill master, and your warfare officers. But I would level these two first. Because Zeus and Alexandria will win you fights you weren't supposed to win. And everyone else will just make sure that you have a good solid base to work from. So, if you disagree with me, I'd love to hear about it. Feel free to make comments down in our comment section. And of course, you can always send me a message. But I will be making more videos going forward on things that we can expand upon from my previous video. But I just really wanted to touch on the officer part because it is that important to me. I wanted to take the extra time to discuss specifically who the best officers are and what you should be leveling in what order. And hopefully that helps you to get a more solid base to win fights you weren't supposed to win and to take on enemies that were far greater than yourself. And with that, I bid you all adieu. Thank you guys so much for your time, and feel free to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. I would really appreciate growing this channel and continuing to make this lovely content, and maybe add a couple more hot takes down the road. Have a good day.